We're going to look at the highest common factor of 54 and 72. Now, there are many ways of doing this. In this video, we'll look at three ways. First of all, we'll have a look at the method that really shows you what we're doing. Then we'll look at the method which I think is probably the simplest one. Then we'll look at one that involves using the prime factors of each of the numbers. And of course, it's always useful to know why you're doing something, and we'll look at a couple of examples. So we'll use an arithmetical example and an algebraic one to see what use this thing is. Okie dokie, so let's start by writing down the factors of each number. So we want the factors of 54. Now, the easiest way to write these down is to pair each factor up. So we know that 1 times 54 is 54, so those are both factors of 54. And 54 is even, so 2 goes in, and that will be 27 times. Does 3 go in? It does, because 3 18s are 54. Now 27 is odd, so if we halve it, we won't get a whole number, so we know 4 doesn't go in. Both 2 and 3 go in, so 6 must go in, and that will be multiplying 9, won't it? And 7, 8, nope, they don't go in, so that's it. We've written down all the factors of 54. So we're going to do the same with 72. So the factors of 72, and we'll do this in the same sort of way. So we start at the ends. So 1 times 72, 72. 72 is even, so we can halve it to get that 36 times 2 is 72. 3 goes in, because 7 plus 2 is 9, which is a multiple of 3. So 3 is into 72 is 24. 36 is even, so we can halve that, can't we? So 4 times 18 is 72. 5 doesn't go in, because 72 doesn't end in a 0 or a 5. 2 and 3 go in, so 6 must go in. And that's 12 times. And 8 9s are 72, aren't they? So I think you've just about fitted them in. Now that we've written down all the factors of both numbers, it's quite straightforward to look at those two lists, and as they're in order, easy to write down the factors that they have in common. So both of these lists have in them 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9s in both of them, and 18. So if we look at that list, the highest one is 18, so the highest common factor of 54 and 72 is 18. So there's our answer. So that method shows what we're doing, doesn't it? We've written down factors of both of the numbers, and we can see when we list them what they are and what the highest one is. So we've then got the highest common factor. But now you know that, there's actually a quicker way of getting the answer. So let's have a look at that. So all we need to do is to write down a little table and the numbers that we're trying to find the highest common factor of. It's only two numbers here, but you could do it with more than two numbers. So we're going to put our numbers up there, and then on the left-hand side, we're going to find numbers that we can see that divide in. First of all, to the numbers at the top, and then to the next line down. So we're looking at 54 and 72, and seeing what we think will go into them. The highest possible number, really, but it doesn't have to be. You could just start with thinking, well, they're both even, so 2 goes in. But let's say we look at those and we think, oh yeah, 6 goes in. Okay, so we write the 6 down and we divide it in. So we say, well, 6 is into 54 goes 9, and 6 into 72 goes 12. And now we've got a much easier problem, because we're only now looking at 9 and 12 and seeing what they have in common. So 2 doesn't go into them, does it? Because 9 is odd. But 3 does go in. So then we divide 3 into both of those numbers. So 3 into 9 goes 3. 3 into 12 goes 4. And now when we look at 3 and 4, there's nothing that they have in common. So we now know that we've finished. So the way that we find the highest common factor is to multiply together all the numbers, in this case it's only two numbers, but the numbers that we've been dividing in on the left-hand side. So we've got 6 times 3 is 18, and that is our highest common factor. So as before, we get the answer of 18, but you can see this is a much quicker way of working through the question. So you start by writing your numbers across the page, look at a number that goes in and divide it into all of them. Then with the numbers that you've got left, see what goes into them. And you keep on and on doing this until the numbers you've got don't have anything in common. Then you multiply together the numbers you've got that you've been dividing in on the left-hand side. So you've divided in 6, you've divided in 3. So altogether, you've divided in 6 times 3. And that's the highest number that goes into both of those numbers. So that's the second way of finding a highest common factor. So let's put that to one side and look at another method. So this method works really well if you're happy writing a number as the product of prime factors. So if we start with 54, and we divide in each prime number as often as we can. So with 54, we know 2 goes in. 2 is the first prime number, isn't it? So 2 into 54 goes 27. 27, well, 3 goes into that, giving us 9. 3 goes in again. So we end up with 54 being 2 times 3 times 3 times 3. In other words, 2 times 3 cubed. So that's 2 times 27, 54. Do the same with 72. So 72, 2 goes in to give us 36. 36 is divisible by 2, so that's another 2. So 2 times 2 times 18. So 2 times 2 times 2 times 9. And 9 is 3 times 3. So that gives us 2 cubed times 3 squared. And then what we're going to do is have a look at what they have in common. And an easy way to visualize this is by doing a Venn diagram. It looks like a Venn diagram. And let's put 54 in the left-hand side and 72 in the right-hand side. So looking at the twos first of all, well, 54 has got one 2 in it, hasn't it? 2 times 3 cubed. But 72 has got 3 2. So in the bit that overlaps, we've just got 1 2. And 54 has got, that's all it's got in the way of 2. 72 has another 2 times 2. And then looking at the 3s, they've both got 3 times 3. So we've got 3 times 3. And that covers 72. But 54 has got another 3. So if we look at each circle, 54 is 2 times 3 times 3 times 3. 72 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 3. And you can see the important bit, the bit where they overlap, gives us the highest common factor, and that's 2 times 3 squared. So you could either draw the diagram or just look at the numbers, the answers, to look at 2 and 2 cubed have 2 in common, 3 cubed and 3 squared have 3 squared in common, giving us the highest common factor of 2 times 3 squared, which is also 18. So that's a method for you if you like working with products of primes. If not, second method is probably a lot easier for you to use. So let's put that to one side. And now we're going to look at a couple of examples where knowing the highest common factor of these two numbers is useful. So let's start with a fraction. So if we've got the fraction 54 over 72, and we want to write it in its simplest terms to cancel the fraction. If we can divide numerator and denominator by the highest common factor, then that will give us the answer in one go, won't it? So we've got 54 divided by 18 is 3. 72 divided by 18 is 4. So we get that fraction simplifies to 3/4. Obviously, we could have done this stage by stage, a bit like with the second method. So, you know, the second method where we've got 6 into 54 goes 9, 6 into 72 goes 12, and we would have got 9 twelfths as our intermediate answer, and then cancel again by dividing both numerator and denominator by 3, and then we would have got the 3/4. So not necessary, but a really quick way of being able to simplify a fraction. And then in algebra, sometimes you're asked to completely factorise or factorise completely something like this. So we've got 54x plus 72y. And if we want to completely factorise that, we want to find the highest common factor of the numbers. There's no letters in common. So we've got 18 times 3x plus 4y. Oops, and we close the bracket there. So there we've used the highest common factor to factorise completely that expression. So again, we could have divided through first of all by 6, and then we would have found that we've got 9x and 12y inside the bracket, and we would have had to do that again, done the factorising again, to get the highest common factor outside the bracket. So the highest common factor is useful in both arithmetic and in algebra.